Get on down with your bass up. Get on down. Listen to the sound. Come on.
Ghost Riot
Radio.
Nick.
The ghost. The ghost himself.
And the ghost with most dead.
Nicky!
Come on!
Bring the ghost.
This one seems to have ghostliness all its own.
Are you a ghost too?
Nick.
It's not stupid, Barbara. We're ghosts.
The only spirits left will be in bottles.
If you can produce ghosts.
Nobody scoffs at ghosts anymore. Apparently, the average ghost is quite reasonable.
A bear in the apartment.
They could be exposing themselves, and you don't want us exposing ourselves.
Well, who knows? You might want us exposing ourselves. What is up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome to Ghost Riot Radio. My name is Nick Noble, and I'm your host here each and every Sunday on Ghost Riot Radio, the 18 and over podcast designed for free-thinking adults just like yourself, currently being recorded here in sunny Sarasota, Florida. As always, I'm going to do a couple of shout-outs, like onecollectiveclothing.com, doing quality 90s hip-hop and streets-inspired tees, hats, and accessories for the kids of yesterday. What is that sound? Somebody's audio is still going nuts. All right, well, whatever. We're just going to keep picking it up. As well as, by the way, if you're looking at the table right now on the YouTube channel, the brand new One Collective gear is out. It's dope. Check it out. Actually, this shirt on your right now is one of the older cuts, but this thing that I'm wearing right now is sick. It's the reverse print on the backside. So dope. Anyway, go check out onecollectiveclothing.com and see what else is coming out in his new line. As well as check out BigTroubleMedia.com, doing graphic web design and print services. They design with an edge and an eye for what is dope. That's BigTroubleMedia.com. And every week on Ghost Riot Radio, I invite a few special people to join me here at the Riot Bench to discuss whatever the hell it is we want to. What is all that background? This is the craziest shit ever. It's a loud noise. It's a noisy episode today, folks, for some reason. This week, I'm fortunate enough to be joined by Grant and Sara, as always. How are you guys?
I'm great.
Fantastic. We are also having a special guest today. He's running a little bit late. Richie Brasil is on his way, originally from Massachusetts, now residing here in Bradenton, Florida. Richie is an artist who is definitely making his presence known, so we'll be talking to him soon. If this is your first time tuning into Ghost Riot Radio, during each episode, I try to feature a new musical artist of the week. If you or your band would like to be featured on an upcoming episode, email me at ghostriotradio@gmail.com. Send me your three best tracks with a bio of yourself and your band, or your band, and any contact info you may want me to air, and I'll do my best to get them on the next available episode. Folks, this week, it is my pleasure to introduce Grimms and blAcknight. Grimms and blAcknight is a dream hop duo based out of Chicago. J.A. Grimms brings a unique touch to the traditional form of rapping with a folk-like approach to storytelling amidst the dreamy, pulsing production and rock-influenced guitar playing of blAcknight. They completed their first U.S. tour in August of this year and are working with producer Brian Deck in the fall of this year. Pretty stuck, pretty dope. So, this first track is off their first of their 2014 album entitled Basement Type Secrets. This is Grimms and blAcknight with Potions.
Fuck the glamour and the glitz, the navel to the tits, the stagnant and the trips. Start ripping off your lips, then ask you for a kiss. Now you said you wanted bliss. Well, there's beauty in the rips. There's beauty when I slip, unstitched and twice dipped, getting quenched from a sip, trying to sink with the ship. So I'll sink with it, bitch. No boundaries when everything's surrounding me, these burdens that are hounding me, just fuck it. My hindsight has astigmatism. Search for working algorithms. Learning from my mother's wisdom. Now I get like 4.6 hours of sleep on an average. Not like I'm upset or opposite bragging, but with the time lagging and jumping in curious motion, I think I'm entitled to moments with potion, 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 potion. I think I'm entitled to moments with potion, 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 potion. I think I'm entitled to moments with potion, potion. I'm drinking on potion, smoking on potion. It's potion, potion. All of it's potion, it's potion. Less of an object and more of an potion, it's potion, it's potion, it's potion, it's potion. I'm nibbling on potion, I'm kissing on potion. All of it's potion, it's potion, it's potion, it's potion. Stand tall, living admirable. Don't question when it's magical. Everything is fathomable. The things that I love so much, it's irrational. The potion keeps me tactical. Truthfully, it's laughable. Mother raised a real diamond in the rough. And even when it's tough, reminded of the love, reminded that I'm one, reminded I am one, and remember I'm a son when I'm loaded like a gun. Now it's back to the potion, potion. I'm smoking on potion, drinking on potion. All of it's potion, it's potion. Less of an object and more of a notion. It's potion, it's potion, it's potion, it's potion, it's potion. I'm nibbling on potion, I'm kissing on potion. All of it's potion, it's potion. All of its potion.
Oh, yeah, ladies and gentlemen, that was Potions by Grimms and blAcknight. Super, super dope. I'm so glad to have these dudes on the show. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with great pleasure that I welcome to the show via Skype, Grimms of Grimms and blAcknight. How are you today, brother?
Great, man. How are you?
Fantastic. Dude, we're glad to have you. So I got on Facebook, as I do daily, sometimes multiple times per day, and my boy Flar posted this video of these cats doing hip-hop stuff. And I immediately lost my mind and was like, I got to find these guys. So I tracked them down immediately and was lucky enough to have these dudes on the show. They got right back to me. And I said hip hop, but I feel like maybe we should describe that a little bit better. I did a bit of digging around, found a few people claiming to have coined the term dream hop. But you guys are doing what you call dream hop. So do us a favor and first explain what dream hop is.
Something that we thought we kind of just thought up to encapsulate whatever we're doing, because it's a little kind of varies genre-wise. So we have Rob's Like Productions, always super ambient, and he's playing guitar and stuff over it. And lyrically, I kind of approach it a little more. I try and paint it with like broad strokes at times. It's just kind of dreamy in general. And yeah, kind of just like these ambient bangers that we were writing and just thought we'll be calling it dream hop.
Sick. It's definitely good. And if you get a chance, I'm going to tell everybody immediately to run over to grimmsandblacknight.com. You can definitely see some videos posted on that page of exactly what's going on here. All right, so tell us a little bit about Grimms and blAcknight, how you got started, and the concept behind the group.
So it's me and guitarist producer of blAcknight. That's my buddy Rob. We kind of grew up together. I was born in Canada, and I moved from Toronto to Michigan when I was like 13, and that's when I met Rob. He was like my first friend.
Nice.
And we used to play music with each other back then in high school, like middle school and high school. He was always a guitarist, and I played drums, so we played like hardcore bands and random stuff like that when we were younger. And then When we turned 18, I like moved to Chicago, and he stayed in Michigan for school. So this kind of was born out of the only way we could collaborate while being apart. So he was like, I'll start producing these beats. And then I was like always into writing, so I started writing like poems and stuff, and like we just combined it that way. So that's kind of how it was born, as a two-piece.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
And you're now officially the second guest that we've had on air who's
from Canada
originally, which is awesome.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
So, yeah. So we're definitely proudly representing Canada right now, which we're happy about. So we did talk a little bit about your first tour, which ended just in August. Tell us a little bit about who you toured with, how it went, what's going on.
So we kind of just did it all ourselves. We wanted to see the West Coast. We wanted to just felt like the right time for us to go out and check out the country and like play music along the way. We didn't tour with any bands, or didn't have it all even booked when we left at the beginning of August. We kind of had like 5 or 6 spots booked, and then we had like a month, and like we had whatever money we had to live through, and we kind of just booked some stuff on the way, played some like DIY spots, and like played on the street sometimes.
Awesome.
Walmart parking lots. Yeah, we went around from like we started in Kansas, went like Austin, then off through Cali, like San Francisco and all that stuff, Portland, Seattle.
That's crazy. And how were you received?
We played a bunch of random shows. Like we played like a couple metal shows actually on the tour. So we'd play a lot of like mixed genre shows, which I see kind of works good for us because I like playing shows where it's like not all hip hop shows. I kind of, it's like another way to stand out and kind of just, I like bridging the gap there. Everyone really liked us. I think we catch a lot of people off guard. It takes like a second or two for people to like maybe catch on right away or just like see where we're coming from. But it's always, once people give it a second, they usually feel it.
That's awesome. That's awesome. Yeah. Your first album came out 2014, correct?
Yep.
How did that do? I've only been able to hear parts of it, so I still haven't been able to absorb it all. Were people receiving that pretty well? Did you guys do okay with it?
Yeah, like that was that kind of gave us the pull to play a lot of shows here in the city. We just released it online independently and stuff. That was kind of like a mix of like songs we were kind of sitting on for a while from when we first started to like. So by the time that stuff came out, we've already were like those songs are almost old to us at that point, but. People really dig it. I'm really proud of that album, Basial Type Secrets. And since then, we've just put out two like singles with B-sides, and then we're working on our new next full length as we speak currently.
Which is the perfect segue into my next question, actually. We mentioned earlier that you're going to be working with producer Brian Deck. For those of you who don't know Brian Deck, he's co-founder of Idful Studios, member of the band Red Red Meat, and it's produced for bands like Modest Mouse and Iron and Wine. I got all that right, right?
Yep, that's all right.
Perfect.
Yep.
So tell us a little bit about what's coming up with him and what else is on the horizon for Grimms and blAcknight.
We got linked up with Brian. We've been talking to him for a couple years. A friend of his told him about us, and they came to our show. And he's like a predominantly like a indie rock type producer. But he's also like a percussionist. He's a drummer and Red Red Meat and stuff, so he has like a percussive background,
right?
And so that was kind of his he wanted to do some like hip-hop type record to make use of like live drums and stuff like that.
Nice.
And so that's kind of how he started talking to us, and we kind of wrote all this new material, and then going back and forth with him, we just kind of got in the studio. Before we left on tour, we recorded a single with him that we're kind of sitting on right now. And last month we started recording the rest of the stuff for the full length. So it's a lot of like live drums, which are being, I'm like playing a lot of them. Brian's playing some, Rob's playing some. It's a lot of like, it's going to be heavily live percussion based, a lot of live guitar.
If you need a place to sneak that out, you want to like leak it out a little bit, you let me know. I'll definitely get it played on the show for you.
Oh, definitely. That sounds great. As soon as we're ready, you'll be the first to know, man.
I like hearing that. That's awesome. And for those of you at home who are hearing that, of course, Diggs is always in the house. Diggs is my dog. We moved the table the other day to try to like make the video look better, and now there's no dig space on that side of the table, so he just... Table's shaking all day long, which is fine. And he just met Richie for the first time, so he's all excited to be here. What can we do? Any of you guys have any questions right now? Everybody's super quiet today. I like it. No, you're feeling good?
Do you like brunch?
I love brunch, yeah.
If you could be one brunch dish, what would you be?
Ooh, if I were to be a brunch dish, let's see.
I told you you'd get a curveball.
Man, that is a curveball. I'm like I guess that'd be some kind of like a Western omelet type, just like a little.
Ooh,
I dig it.
Yeah,
I gotta know why though.
But why? Let's see. Warm and good for the soul, I suppose.
that's an awesome answer, actually.
So, yeah. All right, cool.
You passed. Grimms, man, we're super proud to have you on the show.
I have a question.
Go ahead, Richie.
Is there anyone in the game, in any genre, that you'd want to collab with from anywhere in the world?
Awesome question.
Let's see. As far as like hip hop artists goes, I'm like big fan of the rapper Blue. He's like the stuff Blue in Exile. And
true.
So I'd love to work with Blue. I've always been a big fan of like Tom Waits.
True.
Nice.
Like that'd be cool. Yeah. Those two are good.
Worried.
You know what I love about people these days is nobody's afraid to be like totally opposite side of the spectrum anymore. Yeah. It's not like I just pigeonhole myself. I'm just a hip hop head, or I'm, you know what I mean? People are like,
well, hip hop specifically is sampled from all over the place.
For everybody.
Oh, of course.
You know, it's genres are rooted in so many different types of genres. So agreed. I think it's cool, like now that it's I guess more open minded for people to just collab on all scales.
Agreed. I totally agree with that. Unfortunately, not everybody. I've definitely been around some hip hop heads who are super closed off to the idea that like they just do hip hop, and it's just. You're absolutely right. You're absolutely right. So hopefully everybody is growing the way that you guys are evolving, which is super great. What about your influences other than you know, who you would definitely have your, you know, all Blue being the one guy you'd like to collab with? Who else were you listening to growing up that really influenced you?
Listen to like a lot of soul records. I think like a lot of Sam Cooke and.
I think Otis. We all just got a little excited.
Yeah. I feel like when I write songs, I think a lot about the way Sam Cooke, he can be really to the point with it. And I think about like if I'm writing like anything like love bass, I think he like really killed it on that. Like he can say something so crisp and clear and like not having to like, I don't know, get into like the meat of it. No fat, just kind of like.
Right.
I think about Sam Cooke a lot about that when I write like love based songs. So I guess Sam Cooke was always a big influence for our songwriting. I listen to a lot of Outkast.
Yeah. I was listening to Outkast on the way here.
Oh, nice. Do you have a preference, old or new Outkast? Were you like Spodioti Dopalicious, or do you not care?
They're like the most consistently good.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Even like a lot of Big Boy Soul albums he put out past.
Yeah, absolutely.
So yeah, they're consistent as hell. I love it all. Yeah.
Yeah.
Outkast isn't like Kanye where you have to pick between old and new. You know.
No, I agree. I just always like to know. Sometimes people do, and Kanye, you're right.
True.
We're gonna have a whole show about Kanye. Maybe that's.
Oh, let's not.
I'd like to be a guest.
Consider it.
You
done.
Can take my spot.
All right, gotcha. From all angles, too. I'll look at it from every angle.
Consider it done.
I'm not biased.
Consider it done. We're also going to do... I talked to Austin today, by the way. We're going to do a Sarasota art show.
Word.
We're going to do have a whole podcast just about all the up and coming. And we're not even... I'm jumping the gun. Sorry, everybody who's watching right now. We'll talk art in a minute. All right, so Grimms, what is the best way for people to get a hold of you guys, or if they want to track down your music, what's the best way for people to find you?
So our website, which is grimsandblAcknight.com, all our stuff is consolidated there, like with links and stuff to our Instagram and Facebook and such. You can find us on iTunes or Spotify. You search Grimms and blAcknight. Our Instagram pages, we have separate IGs, so I'm just J.A. Grimms, Rob's Bravo blAcknight, pretty much across the board on social media. I should say blAcknight, you know, people always get confused and think it's like blAcknight, like Renaissance.
Like K-N-I, right.
But it's like a blAcknight like the sky, so that's like something he'd like me to put out there, I'm sure. Nice.
So that's Bravo blAcknight, N-I-G-H-T, not K-N-I, right. So dope. And Grimms is two M's for everybody who's listening. Make sure you go two M's on Grimms.
Two M's on
Grimms,
thank you.
Bro, I can't tell you how excited I am that we got you here on the show.
Yeah,
I think what we want to do right now is play your second track, if you're okay with it. Do you think you want to stick around with us, or should we? Do you have things to do?
I think I'm good. We're good. I'll hang out.
He's going to hang. I love it. All right, so we're going to mute you real quick while we do this second track, and when we bring you back, we're going to talk to Richie Brasil about what's going down with this dude.
Boom.
I'm going to mute everybody real quick. Folks, this next track is off a two-song EP you can find by navigating your way through grimsandblAcknight.com. This is, let me find this extra guy, Grimms and blAcknight holding it down for Chicago with Keep.
endless running while the rain is falling. Someone please hear me calling. These trees tease my perception of my own deception. I'm tracking my progression with very little discretion. I am coming for you now with the pride of the ocean tide. Emotion subside, I'm applied in stride. Bloodied and battered, no matter, I continue. Because I know that I'll be with you. Because I know that I'll be with you. And because I thought that I'd be with you. And because I thought that, now I'm all sidetracked. Got us all sidetracked. So now I'm like, keep that all of your goodbyes. You can keep that the water in your eyes. You can keep that, I'm happy I can see that. I'm better off if you just keep that. And I'll be just fine in the deep and breathing. And I'll be just fine in the deep and breathing.
Perfect.
Oh, you on?
No, you're good. Yeah, we're good. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back.
My bad.
No, you're awesome. That was Keep from Grimms and blAcknight, holding it down for Chicago. Super glad to have you. And we get to keep Grimms on the air, which is dope. So, as I said before from the beginning of the show, you like it?
I do like it.
Yeah, we were drinking that last week, too. Everybody's really happy. That's that Evan Williams single barrel vintage. Mm. Yeah, that's getting passed around this table a little bit. Sorry you can't join us, Grimms, but you've got, hopefully you spiked that coffee.
Spiked.
Okay, good. Perfect. So like I said before, we are also joined today by Richie Brasil. And if you don't know Richie Brasil, it's just because you're late. This dude is blowing up in Sarasota. We're super glad to have him on the show. He finally made it. Glad to have you. How are you, sir?
Yeah, I'm well. I'm very well. I'm a little tired, but I'm well.
Tired is okay. You were working on a website today. Eh?
Yeah. Well, I woke up early. My girlfriend gets up really early to go to work, but I woke up before she did. She has to be at work at 5.
Good. Oh, nice.
I woke up before she did because I went to bed at 9:30, and I'm a night owl and an early bird, so I have to go to bed late.
Right.
To wake up. Regular time.
Oh, okay. Got it. Right.
But I went to bed early with her because I felt like, you know, she'd sleep better if I did.
Sure.
So I did that and I woke up early. She left. Right after she left, the power went out in my house. Neighborhood blackout.
I saw that on Facebook today.
Like, it was crazy. Right after the blackout, sirens everywhere. It's 5 a.m, like, sirens. Like, I'm thinking,
so
like, yo, it's about to go down.
Right. The apocalypse is here.
Or something. And I can see flashlights outside. Like, I was just, anything trips you out that early.
For
you
sure.
Know? I sleep concealed, so I'm straight.
Right.
Yeah. So I was comfortable. I'm chilling. But I'm still, like, you still tripped out. Like, oh, what's going on? I look outside, and it's just blackness. It's just, like, bluish black, you know? And I go out, and my neighbors are out, and everyone's trying to figure out, and there's just sirens, and then their alarm starts going off, and another alarm starts going off. And it just got crazier and crazier from there.
So you're kind of tired this morning.
So even though I was already up, I'm tired from all of that. Yeah. There's a lot of busyness before coffee. I couldn't make coffee because the power's out.
Oh.
So booty cheese. Like.
So glad I don't have that caffeine dependency.
I live
my life. Yeah, I know. All of you hate me, but I live my life all natural. No caffeine in the system anymore.
I'm a really hyper dude, so I need just a little bit to chill me out and balance me.
Whoa, so you, wait, so you caffeine to chill?
Yeah, it like spikes me and then crashes me out and I level. Oh.
There's actually been studies that have shown if you have like ADD or ADHD, caffeine has the opposite effect on you. And so maybe you
No, we're talking like, I was a trial for like liquid Adderall back in the day. Like,
no kidding.
As a kid, patient,
yeah, I was on the
zero.
Liquid stuff. You know, so like I need some sort of something to do something to me.
And as a perfect segue to that, don't forget the Ghost Riot Radio is always pro-green, and all of that stuff can be totally fixed by something a little green that you can grow right in your living room. Which
lawfully.
Lawfully, right.
I don't know how deep we're going today, but I ruined that too.
Yeah, no, this is a green pro. We are pro-green on Ghost Riot Radio. We will, in fact, we're going to go super deep in just a second. All right, so wait, before we get any further, let's talk a little bit about you.
Sorry.
I didn't really preface a whole lot other than I said that you are an up-and-coming artist. I would say you're here now instead of just up-and-coming.
Right.
And you're doing big things here in Sarasota. So tell us a little bit about yourself and about your style and what's going on right now.
Okay, I'll start with my name's Richie Brasil. I'm from Brockton, Massachusetts.
Yeah,
City of Champions, Rocky Marciano, you know, like the real Rocky.
Yeah.
You know?
Wow, yeah.
Like the real champion.
Right.
You know, more titles than Mayweather.
Oh.
Like that, right, you know.
That's a proud statement.
And my hip-hop head. I grew up breakdancing and writing graffiti with Puerto Ricans and Cape Verdeans on the east side of Brockton, you know. I thought breakdancing was my calling, but it was always art. I've always painted and drawn and stuff like that, you know.
Yeah.
But graffiti just was natural to me. It's something that, like, it was, like, the lesser of all evils
right.
in my life, you know? Like, I could be whoever I wanted to be with graffiti instead of, like, some, like, Cape Verdean black kid from, like, the east side, like, short and, like, face full of acne, like, being weird, liking different music in
right.
the hood, you know? It wasn't cool to like what was popping in the hood, you know? And I was that kid that was, like, out of the box a little
right.
bit, you know?
I love that.
I just get picked on for listening to Atmosphere. You
what?
Know? Like, yeah, but it's in the hood, though, what was popping yeah. at the time, like... Like Wu Tang, and I love Wu Tang, you know. But that's what I'm saying.
Right. Everyone loves them some Wu Tang.
I got in a fight with Atmosphere in Boulder.
Really?
Yeah.
I saw Idea punch a kid in the face at Warped Tour, like 05.
Oh. He probably would have tried to punch me in the face, but I was in the balcony, so we just had like a screaming match. Really, I keep telling people it's a fight, but
we should ask Madison about that because he might have been on that Warped Tour.
Oh, oh snap!
Yeah, that would be crazy. So yeah. So anyway, side note. I just talk shit like. Whatever. I was young. It was fun. So I also grew up as a hip hop head. So I love, you know, I don't know if you noticed as you walked in.
I did
but
notice.
You've been prominent in my living room since the day I met you, actually. So Richie Brasil is definitely alive and well in my household. And as somebody who grew up, I've been trying to support the hip hop scene here in Sarasota
right.
for a while. And right. It's doing its thing, actually. I think it's coming up.
It's popping off now.
Things are coming
like, it
up.
It really is. Like, it's got its own thing. Like, you can go to Ybor, find that thing.
Right.
St. Pete, you know. Orlando, definitely.
Right.
But I know cats from Orlando scene that come to Sarasota, you know.
Which is great.
Arts, Rhyme, and Beer and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Like, it's a big deal now. It's popping. Like, you know, DJ Celis has definitely made it popping here.
Absolutely.
Shahid has made it popping here. Kliz has made it popping here.
We'll
you
get
know?
Shahid
I
here
like
eventually.
Shahid.
Yo, Shahid is my guy, dude.
We'll get that him
here
eventually.
That's my brother.
So we brought Knowledge Austin on here not too long
Word.
Ago. That dude just dropped his mixtape, which is awesome. If
True.
You haven't heard it, it's on SoundCloud. So good.
Knowledge Austin.
Knowledge yeah. Austin.
I haven't heard. There's a kid that did a show at Austin Kowal's, not Knowledge Austin's.
Yep.
I can't think of his name.
Was he like braided long
was
hair?
Was he the no, one wearing the
hat?
Overalls?
Short white kid hat.
The one from that party.
Yeah.
Christmas, the Halloween party.
Maybe.
But you know when someone throws you their mixtape and you're just like, I don't really want to do this right now.
Right.
Yeah.
But I gave it a listen and I was like, yo, he got bars, dude.
Yo.
Like, it's, be careful with who you, like, don't pay attention to, who you sleep on around here, you
I
know?
I have a question, Ricky.
Richie,
sorry.
It happens.
What do you think of mumble rap?
I got a love-hate relationship with it. Personally, I hate it.
Yeah.
But every now and then, I'll catch myself going, damn it. I'm really not a fan of anything like that but lyricism. You know, I do love hardcore lyricists. I like rappers that write their own raps. Can I swear?
Yes.
Yeah.
I like rappers that write their own shit. Like, yeah, get out of my face with that, like, oh, someone else wrote it. Like, I don't count, like, people like Dr. Dre as a rapper. You
right.
know? Like, I don't count people like Puffy as a rapper. Like,
oh.
you're a mogul, you're whatever. But, like, you know, I'm not a fan of Drake at all.
No, me neither.
Not even a little bit. Like, there are some tracks I did enjoy.
This is why he's been invited here, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm at that place where I'm the old guy now because I like bars. And I like lyricism, and I like a clean boom bat. Took time.
Rhythm and poetry.
You know, exactly, you know? Like, I'm sorry, I grew up learning the elements of hip hop.
Right.
I grew up head spinning, break dancing, yes, all that stuff, you know? I'm still on the B-boy crew. I don't really do much of it, but I rep it. Like,
dope. What is it? Like the ABCs?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But regardless of how I feel about mumble rap, what I don't like is rappers that come into the game saying they don't have to learn anything about the other rappers. Like, right, the mumble rappers that hate on the old school cats.
Which is happening. I don't understand why that happens. Like, you see these dudes in interviews just talking shit.
But if the old school cat hates on you, you have to take it. It's like any other field. Agreed. Like any job, any profession. Like when you go on, like you're the new guy. Like you're, you know, you're the one who's, you know, who might not be here in a couple of years. Well, the old guys are still here. They're still doing their thing. So if you don't respect them and you get booed and you think because you're popping and making money off that track now, like don't think like your longevity will last forever, bro. Like,
agreed.
Like, chill out.
I totally agree.
Take it easy.
Grims, we still got you on the line. Since you're a musician also and you're doing a hip-hop styled track yourself, how do you feel about mumble rap? Are you following any of those dudes?
I mean, I hear it in passing and stuff. It's nothing I really seek out too much, but not really my thing. But at the same time, I don't really even put the time into like hating on it or trying to like
legit.
That's,
yeah.
I just,
not wanting to hate on stuff is okay too. Keeping your life low stress is always a good idea. Richie's coming back.
21 Savage though got bars.
I don't even know that dude.
He's the craziest looking one out of all of them. He's got the dagger in the middle of his head. It looks like a cross.
What do you mean, like tattooed?
Yeah. Oh, he's like, man, you know, the half dreads, dagger, you know, like mumbles a lot. But I watched something on Vox or Rap Genius, and I was listening to him, and I was like, damn, like he's like ODB mixed with like Gucci Man. Like, but
what?
That is the weirdest combination I've ever heard.
But in Soulja Boy's body. You know?
Okay. Now I'm just
like,
I just gave up.
Like when I hear 21 Savage, I believe him. Like everything he's spitting, I'm like, wow, like you really run up in your house and really like sleep with my mom's real quick.
We're gonna check him out. All right, hold on. I'm gonna do this real quick because now Jocelyn is a fucking, this is changes. I'm just gonna play like a hot second. We're all just gonna talk over it, which is fine. Just absorb this. Running across town with a plastic crown, that's till I shut it down. A, he produces everything himself.
Word.
It's all him.
And he's super young, too.
17 years old.
Yeah. He's a baby.
What's he look like?
Handsome. Cruising like a
Cadillac. That's my memo. I don't think y'all got it. I just put the track on mute so y'all can hand me all my bars back. Matter of fact. Just bring it back with independent assassins. All right, I'm getting out of control right now. But you get the idea. That's Knowledge Austin, everybody. If you've been watching this show at all, he's been on here twice. We did a special edition for him. I'd play the shit out of that kid. I love him to death. So we're glad. So let's talk a little bit about your art now.
Sorry.
We've been talking about hip. No, no, not at all. I think this is a great conversation. I'll talk hip hop all day long. And I'm the opposite. I did everything except the break dancing portion.
True.
I actually have a lot of rhythm, but I can't. I just can't
balance.
Yeah, my body's, it's not happening. Especially now. I just had shoulder surgery. This is as high as my arm gets. There's no more breaking anything.
Oh, you could tuck that arm and catch that windmill. You could do it.
You can show me later.
I did a windmill like last week and it hurt for a while.
Yeah? See, all right. So I'm not doing that shit at all. That's not happening. But, so you are an artist.
Right.
And I own your work, which I'm proud to display.
Appreciate
it. Tell us a little bit about your style. Obviously, you came up as a hip-hop head, so graffiti is heavy.
Yeah.
Tell us what set you apart, what brought you to Sarasota, like, where, let's just...
Okay, there was art before there was graffiti. Like,
sure.
I was making, like, toys and stuff like that, making my own, like, little figures. I would get
out
lined paper, draw them
out
on lime paper with like a ballpoint pen, and I'd like do little dots and I'd poke them out and I'd glue them to like sticks and stuff. My cousins and I. Yo, it was real. It was the hood.
That's dope.
But so like I always did like figure drawing and stuff like that. I always loved the arts, like Van Gogh. I always studied it, you know. But I never like thought like, hey, you could make it out of here and be one yourself, you know.
Right.
Even on a small scale, like I could sell a painting. Never dawned on me. Just even when people told me, I was just like, yeah, whatever. Like,
yeah.
I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to college. I'm not doing this. I'm not doing that.
I'll tell you from my experience, I didn't even know how to do it. When it first came to me, people were like, I want to buy your work. And I was like, what? Like, okay. They're like, how much? I was like, I have no fucking clue. Like, I have no idea. What's it worth? I don't know. And they're like, well, you got to take your time and multiply that by your cost.
Oh, that's
and
all trash.
Like, fuck that. Like, here's what I'm going to do. I'm gonna put a dollar amount on how much that shit is really worth to me and how much I'm willing to part with it for.
I started off with, like, major pieces was, like, how much is the rent and if I can get, like, a meal or two. No, like, dead ass. Like,
so good. Rent, bravo to you.
So all my pieces were starting off, like, $750-something.
Bro. That's so good.
And people were like, yeah. And I was like, word? And they were like, hell yeah. For a six-foot painting? All day.
Yeah.
And I was
yeah.
like... maybe I should change something.
I almost bought. You had what? You were doing 4x4s. Were they four or three?
Nah, some are 3x6 and 5x6 or something like that.
Okay.
Some are so huge. Some are small.
The last show we were, you all saw us again at Solid SRQ, and the first place I met Richie was that spot when he did a show. It's where I bought his work, and he has a couple of pieces that would definitely be here, except I'm broke because y'all aren't helping me out. So
a dollar a day.
Right, it's true. Oh, we'll talk about never mind, we'll talk about it later. His work is fantastic, just fantastic. And if you are a graph head at all, if you have any respect for graffiti as an art, his work is great. Like, just great. It's the kind of stuff that transcends
right.
graffiti too. Like, it's not just,
well, that's the point.
Right, absolutely. Yeah. It's the kind of thing that you'd be happy to hang in your living room or in your dining room and still, you know that it's got that street feel, but is also, like, abstract and perfect. It just has, like, it's hard lines and, like, all the stuff that I love about graffiti, but it also has, like, great color usage and
studying, man.
As an artist, like, I chase artwork.
Well, I try to separate graffiti itself, because I like doing it as pure as possible,
right.
and I try to separate it from what I do with my personal work, where in the sense where I take elements of graffiti along with, like, you know, I use spray paint still,
right,
or like the layering process, and I use those, but I don't necessarily put graffiti on canvases. I think that's, I don't know, it is what it is, but I try to stay away from that because I have so many ideas pumping right. through my head. Like, I can do more than just do the obvious.
Agreed.
So that's where I'm at now. I like doing a lot of photorealistic stuff with spray paint.
Yeah.
You know, especially the cheap stuff, because it's really hard. And that definitely sets you apart right then and there.
So let's talk about that real quick, because you recently got commissioned to do a pretty massive mural.
I started it recently and I finished it recently, but I was commissioned to do that a long time ago.
So you were late, but that's all right. That's...
No, it's just, you know, like, business. It's just different side, you know? That's what art is. It's business. Most,
agreed.
You know?
It's trust me. I
90% business, 10% art.
Art.
Yeah.
So tell us about the concept and whether, was that all you, or was that something that, you know, they sort of kind of gave you guidelines on, and then...
I'd say it was collaborative effort. Like, I got approached through one gallery that I didn't get showed in, which, whatever. But I got these clients out of them, and they love graffiti and love street art. And I met with them a few times. I, you know, basically sat down, like I'm sitting here, and told them about my life and showed them my work. And they were like, you're the guy. You're the guy we've been looking for.
It's true.
And they're like, we want to do some paintings on this building. We don't know what. What do you have? And I think I did 8 different sketches. And all of them were hardcore, like things I wanted to paint, things I came up with. And then we were like, we were digging deeper in that area, and we found out all the rich history in the Rosemary District, you know, with the black culture and the indigenous people and stuff like that. And we were like, yo, we should do like this and this. And he was like, yeah, that's what we're doing. Like,
fire.
And he's like, I don't want any white people up. And I was like, word.
There's plenty of those.
Say no
here.
More, fam.
We can make that happen.
And I was like, all right, like that, if that's what you want. And he's like, yeah, like this area used to be predominantly black, and like now, like it's getting gentrified, and I know I'm a builder, and like just all this like crazy stuff coming from this guy. And I was just like, yo, I feel you, bro. Like, damn, you must be from the hood, but kind of not, you know?
No.
I love that.
The guy grew up in like Washington, D.C., but just understood.
Hey.
Yeah. Understood like what he was as a builder and what, you know, what needed to be there, and like preserving the history without, you know, with building some new things too, you know?
Yeah.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, it was the real deal. And so I was somewhat honored to do it, you know? If he was like, no, I'm not going to do this anymore, I'd be like, yo, like, pay for the paint. Like, you still need to get done. Like, just on a human level, you know? And that's really nice, like, when you can do things like that doesn't, I guess, overstep your own morals as a person or human being, like, it's really gratifying.
It's crazy. You know? It's crazy. I'm so proud of you. It was awesome to be able to watch, not only, you know, I follow you on Instagram and the social media stuff, but also the paper was picking you up.
Before that and after, like right before that, I had like three magazine releases, nice. Which was dope. Yeah. Like I was just like, what? I'm on vacation. I'm hot right now. Like I need to go home. And then like, as soon as I got back, riding the wave off the show, they were just like, oh, what are you doing now? And I'm like, well, check this out. And they're like, oh my goodness. And then all these newscasts kept coming out. I think I have one more interview set up that I have to do for it, actually.
Sick.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it's like three or four months later. But there was some backlash, you know, because it's big brown people, big colorful brown people going up in the South. Like, so they're regulating murals now in Sarasota.
That sounds like a totally Sarasota thing to do.
Yeah, well, like...
That's fucked up.
I hate to say it's my fault, but I think it's kind of like, you know, I did this big-ass mural in Sarasota, and now they're regulating murals all of a sudden, you know? And it brought a lot of awareness to what had happened in that area.
Yeah, of course.
Rosemary District was called the Rosemary District in 1992. Before them, it was called Overtown, meaning the town over there, meaning the town where the black people are. And before that, it was called Black Bottom, because... It's rock bottom. It's where the black people are again. Like,
dude,
so.
I can't. That shit is stomach turning.
It's wild, bro.
it's seriously. And so, just so everybody knows, first and foremost, Ghost Riot Radio does not give a fuck what color you are. We don't give a shit. We love everybody. If you're awesome, you're awesome. If you suck, you suck. And that's the end of it. Bottom line, we will support the shit out of everybody, no matter what.
Just as long as you're not a dick.
As long as you're not a dick. Word. Hashtag don't be a dick. Madison started it. We're going to keep it up. And I'm going to put it right on the screen tonight for this show. So, yeah, we're super proud of you, man. I think it's fucking awesome.
Thank you, man.
Doing. Absolutely.
Yeah.
I think
appreciate
it's great. So talk to me about where people can find you or purchase your work.
Well, as of today, as of literally like
great timing.
A half hour ago, richiebrasil.com, Instagram richiebrasil, Twitter Richie Brasil, Snapchat Il Brasil,
I L L Brasil, Brasil,
Brizill.
Oh,
I kept it ill twice, you know. It's extra.
All right, so
it's actually my gamer tag.
I'll make sure on PlayStation.
PlayStation,
or Xbox?
Baby.
Fuck yeah, we're coming, dude. It's good. What are you playing right
Destiny.
Now?
Destiny.
Oh my god, I know what we're doing for the rest of the day.
Our lives over. You want a raid, bro?
Done. So good. Oh, God. I'm going to smoke a lot of weed and fucking play that shit. Oh,
I'm going to ignore a lot of girlfriend.
Summer. It's summer, right?
Summer.
Summer. It's good to see you.
My
Hello.
Bad, babe.
Yeah.
I owe you a back rub.
I'm stealing
you.
Your bro. Sorry.
She knows. She can. Yo.
She throws down?
Crucibles, bro. That's how I got down with Destiny. She used to school me in Halo, bro.
All right. So, ladies, if you're out there and you're single, that's also what I'm looking for, is somebody who is also down with the game, and we'll figure it out. Fuck it. That was the lamest shit I've done on the air so far.
I want to punch you right now.
I know you do. It's okay. So I tell you what, Richie, we're super glad to have you. Normally what we do here, because we're super pro-green, is I'm starting this whole project called The Week in Weed.
True.
And so I've been talking to the guys over at normal.org. Normal is the National Organization for the Reform of Marijuana Law.
Mm-hmm.
Those guys have been around since the 60s trying to push for, you know, reforming this war on drugs, which is, you know, obviously a terrible thing.
It's and a real war.
It is. Yeah. It is. Are you ready for this? We're going to talk about some serious shit right now. So, The Week in Weed, brought to you by normal.org. We're going to talk a little bit about the very first article I found on those guys today. Let me start by saying that I made a vow not to make this show about politics. I think it's an ugly way to go. You all are allowed to be free thinking. We talk about wanting this to be a show for free thinking adults. Be free thinking. Think what you think. But I'm going to try to sway you a little bit on the stuff that we're going to that drives this show. So since we're pro cannabis, and when it comes to legalizing cannabis, we think that it should be legal for the entire country, no matter what. And we're going to get involved. So that being said, if you recall last week's episode, I seemed a little concerned about President-elect Trump wanting to appoint someone into office who was very anti-cannabis. It turns out that office is the attorney general position, and that person is Alabama Senator Jeff Sessions, who is currently serving on Trump's transition team. Here's my issues with Jeff Sessions. Sessions has been anti-drug reform for his entire 19 years in the U.S. Senate. He was quoted as saying, and I quote, good people do not use marijuana. I don't know what his definition of good people is.
I know you, a lot of bad people. Bro.
Yeah, you tell that racist motherfucker. Anyway, so, and when you go, whoa, Nick, you're jumping the gun. I don't think that I am. First of all, he sounds an awful lot like a certain person by the name of Harry Anslinger. And if you don't know who that guy was, he was the first commissioner of the Federal Bureau of Narcotics, whose entire platform against cannabis was trying to rid the country of Mexican immigrants who were making their way to the U.S. after the Mexican Revolutionary War, or Revolution of 1910. He pinned all violence, crime, and, quote, socially deviant behavior on Mexican people and blamed them for bringing cannabis into this country. Shortly after that, within that next year, 29 countries totally went anti-cannabis, which is fucking ridiculous in our opinion. So, Nick, what does that have to do with Jeff Sessions? Let me tell you. While serving as U.S. attorney in Alabama, he called an African-American assistant U.S. attorney, boy, quote-unquote, insisted that the NAACP was, quote, un-American, and said, and I quote, he was okay with the Ku Klux Klan until he learned they smoked pot. He's a giant fucking dinosaur, and I can't wait.
Well, Klanmans aren't good people, so.
You're right.
Oh, clearly.
Because they smoke marijuana.
Only because they smoke marijuana.
Right.
The devil's
right.
lettuce.
Ridiculous. Let's talk a little bit about our saving grace, because it seems that Sessions will have to be approved by the U.S. Senate before getting into this position. And unfortunately, well, fortunately for us, this will be the second time that Sessions went in front of the U.S. Senate for approval. The first time was in 1986 when he was up for a federal judgeship in which he was denied by the Senate after they found out about his history of making racist comments. So, now you know the history of the man. Go out there right now. There's a lot of people protesting all kinds of things that really, honestly, you can't change at this point. But it's time to start changing things that you can get behind. And things like whether or not our Senate should fucking vote yes on a man who is obviously hating on people who are, really, honestly, as a white man, we are the minority in this country. And it's about fucking time that somebody else did something, because we've been fucking it up for too damn long. It's time that we started becoming a unified country. Instead of this racially biased country, no more of that shit. Stop putting people into office who believe that kind of shit. That's my rant. Fucking vote green for the rest of our lives. Does anybody have anything they want to talk about right now? You do. Yo,
I just want to get mad ad libs. Like, damn.
Do. Please do. And I, you know, very rarely am I going to make a stand on certain things, but that shit is totally unacceptable. Man. Trump.
Infuriating.
Trump is making a terrible decision that way.
I kind of want to quit art and open up like a taco stand or something like that.
Yeah.
Well, that sounds awesome
corner,
too.
You know?
That's an art in itself. You're never. Feel free, by the way, if you're out there and you make tacos, to donate your time. We'll happily promote you. Bring us tacos. We will promote the shit out of tacos on this show. But no, you're absolutely right.
And if you're Cuban, I'll take some mofongo.
Oh, shit.
Just saying.
All right, so Sarasota is dying for some more international options here. So please, come on down. Enjoy the beaches and awesome weather. And help us create a better Sarasota, because we are ready to just kind of bleed out, and we're coming for you. It's gonna be awesome.
I would kill for some menudo.
Swear to God, so good. Grims, you doing all right over there, bro?
Great. Starving now.
I'm sorry. You live in Chicago. What part of Chicago are you in?
I'm like on the Ukrainian Village, Humboldt Park. It's like the west of downtown, west side.
Nice. True. You live pretty close to my homie Flar, right?
Really close, yeah. Same neighborhood. We're in a band together, actually.
Shut. I didn't know that. That's awesome.
Yeah, for a little bit. We jammed for a while. That's how we started hanging out.
So he's got some new projects coming up. He just invited me to come out beginning of next year to possibly film some new stuff that's dropping for those guys. So I may be in your neighborhood very soon.
Great. He lives right down the street. He plays Destiny a lot too. Also, he'd be so.
Yo, trust me. I know.
Add me.
Trust
right
me,
now.
I know. He's who I play with. I literally know nobody else, but I play with that dude regularly. So we may be coming to your neighborhood and doing another one of these podcasts. Maybe we'll go to Archie's. You all did a video at Archie's, right?
Yeah, that's our spot.
Yo. Yeah. It looks like the perfect, it's like the perfect dive bar. Like, it just looks like everybody drinks beer out of cans, and it just looks, I can't wait. We're just gonna drink whiskey and cheap beers and have a good time.
Can't wait.
Yeah, I'm stoked. All right, so, you know, again, we're very pro-green. Again, since Amendment 2 passed here in Florida, we're looking at the possibility of medical marijuana for everybody, compassionate care for the rest of us, as long as nobody comes into office and fucks shit up for us right now. Don't forget that if you are in the Florida area and you are trying to figure out whether or not you qualify for compassionate care, go check out docmj.com. That's docmj.com. Take a quick survey. They'll get back to you as fast as possible. Don't be surprised if they send you a text message, because people at this table, well, myself, has received these text messages and thought it was weird that I got a text message from these guys. But they're legit. Text them back. Get your stuff set up. Find out whether or not you qualify. But, side note, don't forget, if you're a concealed carry permit holder in the state of Florida or really across the country, it sounds like they may be trying to not allow you to have both, which is some serious bullshit.
You know, I was getting to my next point.
I know.
Because I don't smoke, but I suffer from ADHD and anxiety and stuff like that. Yeah. So I'd be curious to talk to someone to look for a blend that might help with a lot of my issues that I have.
But if it becomes a question of concealed carry or green, will you stay anxious?
No, I guess I would. I would stay anxious. Right, yeah, right. Like,
I'm just fucked up. It's fucked up that you should have to choose between the two.
Right.
So here's my answer. I'm going to keep my concealed carry permit and continue to smoke weed illegally, and you can come fucking get me if you want to. But you haven't caught me so far, and you're not going to catch me fucking ever, so good luck.
I got a lot of friends in law enforcement, and I think that they would even say, like, that is nothing they're trying to, like, run after.
It's never
like, they
gonna,
don't give
no.
a damn either. Like, nope. Not that they don't give a damn. Like, they care about their laws, but, like, that's something that, like, it's kind of a waste of their time, too, and they understand that.
From what I read on the reasoning behind it is because...
Oh, there you are.
I've been waiting. Well, actually, I had a question about your artwork, too.
Like,
maybe
game of Double Dutch, bro.
Garth's back. What's
up? Ever play Double Dutch?
So, yeah. Hop in. Do it at the same time. So, the explanation behind the reason why it's illegal or that it overlaps is because on the form for registry, like, it says, like, are you addicted to marijuana or any of these other drugs? So, like, by having that card, they say, like, that you're in it. And because they still call it a Schedule 1, you know, addictive drug substance, that makes you automatically a drug addict.
Bullshit.
By having your green card.
It's pure bullshit.
You know what I've been trying to knock off for most of my life? Freaking nicotine.
Yeah.
Like, you know?
Yeah. What about this? We're all
drinking right now.
Openly consuming alcohol.
Yeah.
Allegedly.
allegedly consuming alcohol.
I can go months without drinking and still crave it.
It's so socially easy to do.
Like weed? Are you serious?
Yeah. Like, I know. I totally agree.
Like, I just don't get the logic behind weed.
Well, you can't start a war on drugs on a product and then expect that it's going to die easily, and that's the only answer. That's really the only answer.
A lot of brown people smoke weed.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Now I know how to... Yes! So if I want to attract more brown people...
Oh, my God.
Which I do. That's the answer. Is I don't give a shit what color you are.
But
come hang out.
It's proven that Caucasians or white people or the other demographic smokes at the same rate and...
Maybe more.
Like, I'm saying, because I mean, who knows those statistics? Like,
maybe
they don't get caught
more.
With shit. They don't get in trouble with shit. Like,
I know for sure if I watch YouTube right now, the fucking some of the biggest names on the smokiest channels are all white dudes.
I know people in high places right now, like on personal levels, that smoke weed.
Yeah.
Like.
Listen, being from DC, the Washingtonian did a whole article spread about pot on the Hill, and really honestly, it's everywhere, right down to a woman who was delivering baked goods to people in their offices.
That's ill.
That was medicated.
Yo, that was my job, though. That'd be ill.
Ill.
That's how you.
But you'd have
made
to be
it.
Terrified too. You'd have to like every delivery would
yo,
be
check
a
out
little
my
bit
art
nerve.
Too.
You'd have to go burn one or eat a brownie just to make sure that you could get through that office all the way to your delivery spot. But listen, here's the deal. The bottom line on green is that it's not going anywhere. Whether you make it illegal or not, just like literally any drug, those who want it will find it. and those who don't want it will try to pretend it's not there. And that's really the bottom line. So it's time to change the laws, because right now we're just putting people in jail for no fucking reason, for over a plant that was here before we were. And it's not like anybody created that or tried to make it. It's literally just something that was here that we found some benefit from. And now it's proven to do better.
A lot things. Of great things.
So many great. Did you know that you can now buy CBD crystals? If you don't know, let's go real quick. Educate. THC, there's two active ingredients in marijuana and cannabis. THC, which is the one we all find, know, and love, that is awesome. But CBD is the active ingredient that is found so many medical benefits from. And you can now buy CBD crystals by themselves. There's a ton of great companies out there doing just pure CBD crystal. And you can dab, smoke, do whatever you
prefer. You can buy the oils and vape it.
Yeah, totally.
I know friends that vape stuff.
CBD has been known, and for those of you out there, I found this out yesterday. If you have a moment where you ate that brownie and it was too damn much, you probably should have only eaten half like somebody told you to in the first place, and you are too high, you can then take a little CBD, and it will help mellow you out. Yeah. It's a plant that fixes itself. That's fucking crazy.
That's ill. You can't do that with alcohol.
You can't do that with fucking anything.
No.
You can't do that with anything.
I need to quit smoking cigarettes. I'll just smoke a cigarette. Really.
I got a video for you. I got a whole guy who's all about smoking, quitting cigarettes by smoking weed. I love this guy.
Hey, man.
In fact, I'm going to shout him out right now. Go check out Custom Grow 420 on YouTube. That dude is the smokiest cat I've ever seen in my life. But he's hilarious, and he's in Washington State. And he's really, like, I've never seen anybody who is so composed and sticks to his game plan on every episode as well as this guy does, in the condition that he should be in after how much consumption he takes in. But amazing. He's hilarious. And if you're looking for, like, new products or what's going on, he's doing all kinds of awesome reviews. So that's Custom Grow 420. Go check him out on YouTube. All right, so let's stop being so serious for a second. At the beginning of this show, because we had a guest join us today on Skype, we tried to continue the trend of doing an adult Mad Lib, which we set up at the beginning of this show. And had Richie been here, we definitely would have included him on some of these answers. But we decided that we were going to go ahead and fill this out. We're going to read it to you right now. This is called How to Hire a Prostitute for Sex.
Damn.
Yeah. This is going
to
be...
As opposed to just chores around just the house.
Just like back rubs. Yeah, or...
I have one that rakes my leaves all the time.
Which is weird in Florida. It's just
they're
giant
cheap,
palms.
They're cheap labor. I mean,
all right. So this is how to hire a prostitute for sex. Sex is apparently one of the most natural and sticky acts that can occur between 2 to 42 people. But sometimes sex is not readily runny. If you are spooning a creep... Or a leper. That's really weird. In such cases, you may wish to fuck a prostitute to fulfill your smelly needs. The following steps will ensure a successful hire and an intelligent 3 to 5 minute session for all. Damn, that's wrong. Bring cash. Fewer than 69%, awkward, of prostitutes poop when you pretend to run your green card through their cleavage. Find a prostitute. They gather in packs near downtown lovable holes in hopes their numbers will protect them from cavernous guinea pigs.
I don't.
You will want to look as little like a guinea pig as possible. Note, if a prostitute says, "Hey there, guinea pig," he or she is testing you. Do not fart or the pack will crawl. Instead, dig the prostitute in the finger and try a harmless bird call to set him or her at ease. Nice. Oh, that was much less harmless than mine. In certain cities, they can also be found in the broken pages. Broken pages? Yeah, probably. They're prostitutes. Just open up the bony book, and there they are. Know the lingo. First, things are less enticing to a prostitute than improper syntax and airplane usage. If you want to be absolutely sure to suck at least these few pale street terms, this is just getting ridiculous. Hooker. A prostitute, specifically one that uses whales to catch his or her clients. That's true. People with money, yeah. John, a prostitute's dick. A toilet. These are definitions, apparently. They just threw these in here randomly. Three, both for $7.95 extra. That's fucking weird. Rolling.
The optional rubbing and or planking of a hungry John after the conclusion of a successful transaction. Lots of planking afterwards. Who knows? You got to keep those abs up.
They still plank? That's still a thing?
I don't know. Apparently in prostitution, it's a good...
It's intimate. Right.
In sleepy cases, may lead to involuntary ear donation. I don't know what that is. If you
circling back to Van Gogh.
If you choose to be rolled, make sure your slowly license features a donor sticker, just in case. I don't know what your slowly license is, but good luck with that. Ask if the prostitute is actually an undercover prostitute officer. They're required by law to slap you if they are. Once revealed, they will often give you a fish if the prostitute department is under particularly famished budget crunch. They have a fish.
These are your old laws.
Find a dirty spot once you've succeeded in eating your prostitute. Good.
Oh, God. Gee. This is... I don't know.
You're going to want to fuck your success to the taint by painting the most slimy place you can without getting arrested.
I'm so glad my grandmother isn't on Facebook.
Yeah, sorry. Sorry. Nothing sets the mood better than the fuckable street lighting, smiling off a carpet of broken gashes around its tits. So always try the alley behind the moon. Remember that other Johns will have had the same cheese, so you may want to keep a colorful location in mind. Appropriate places include ornery corpse playgrounds, dead cars, or a corner gash at the nearest Lowe's.
Corpse playgrounds? Like a cemetery?
Yeah.
This is street lingo, I think. This just says, period, puke, sex. I can't help you here. This article is only about drinks a prostitute. I think this is written by somebody who doesn't speak English. Having the dick is your business. That's legitimate. Get away, girthy. No one has figured out this step. Congratulations, you have successfully splashed a prostitute for sex. Note that this guide is for burning a prostitute for sex. It's really hard to read this. For information on itching a prostitute for home repair, see the article, How to Hire a Prostitute for Home Repair. Hmm. Also note, home repair is usually done by a barber. Okay.
We really went full circle there.
Yeah, it's a little weird. Yeah. Sometimes prostitutes end up being members of a gender you don't expect. If this happens, don't freak out.
How many? I don't know. Never mind.
You will talk to the prostitute, and they are known to suck. Just accept the mouthy slowly, like when a banana you thought was chocolate turns out to be a pistachio. What the fuck? This is best not to try to burp a conversation with a prostitute unless you discover you slurp something in common, like an interest in boobies or a twat.
That one was major key. Like, don't burp a conversation with a prostitute.
Right, unless you slurp something in common, well, like an interest often, in boobies or a twat addiction.
You know, burp things up, like, you know, a certain sense or actual, you know.
It can be offensive.
You know?
It can be.
That, so, and you're not going to win with whatever, like, you ate or have consumed against a prostitute.
So that's How to Hire a Prostitute for Sex, as per Ghost Riot Radio, thanks to the adult Mad Lib search on Word blanks, something. Who knows? Fuck it. It's already gone. That was ridiculous, and so I'm really glad we did that.
I'm pretty sure that whoever came up with that did not speak English.
Well, yeah.
Or
was it
has
written,
never hired a prostitute.
Was it written correctly? Or were the words written correctly?
I feel like some of the sentence structure is broken already, and so therefore you have
true.
To... It's not... They're not legitimate Mad Libs. We're not coining... Like, the copyrighted Mad Lib people out there, it's not yours. We're going to wordblanks.com, so who knows who's writing those, but... They tend to be a little bit ridiculous, which we like on this show. So, folks, does anybody have anything else they need to plug today? I think we're going to go ahead and wrap this show up.
I'll be at Art Basel next week.
Oh
nice.
Yeah. Painting with the homies. Can't say who, can't say which ones. But I'll be there painting as Richie Brasil and as, yeah. So, check me out. Follow me.
Six. And tell them again how to follow you.
RichieBrasil.com. Oh, it feels so good saying.
Doesn't it?
Wow.
Doesn't it?
.com. RichieBrasil.com.
So good.
Three W's in front of that if you want.
Yeah. Three W's is a good
if you're feeling feisty.
Yeah. Right. If you're just really good at typing, you're like, I got this pinky. Don't worry about it. Bing, bing, bing. All right. So let's go ahead and say thanks to Grims. Grims, how you doing, brother? You good?
Doing great. Thank you for having me. I had a great time.
Dude, we had a blast. We're super glad to find you. So I was going to read it, but I think maybe you should do it. Tell everybody again the best ways to find you guys.
Hit us up on grimsandblacknight.com. Two M's and Grimms. Blacknight like the sky. And then .com. Our IGs are J Grimms for me and Bravo Blacknight for the Blacknight. And keep a lookout. Our new album's going to be dropping soon. We're recording it now, so updates will be being peppered out throughout the next coming months here. We're really excited.
Sweet. And is your website the best place to find that when it drops?
Yeah, you can find our website for updates or our social media page, our Facebook, Grimms and Blacknight. Just search on there. We'll keep you all updated.
Sweet. And we don't forget that if you're looking for the stuff that's already out, you can find them on Bandcamp.com, SoundCloud.com, Spotify as well. These dudes are awesome. Mm-hmm. Dude, we're super glad to have you. Sorry Black Knight couldn't make it. Maybe we'll get him on the next one, or definitely when I come out your way. We're going to definitely go.
I'm excited.
Yeah, bro. I'm stoked for sure. All right, folks. So that's grimsandblacknight.com. BLACKNIGHT, not two Ks. And that's Grimms with two Ms. Don't forget that. Guys, we're super happy to have you. Thank you so much for being on the show. As for me, make sure you follow us on Facebook.com at Ghost Riot Radio. You can also follow me personally at Ghost Riot Media, which is the umbrella for this entire project. On Twitter and Instagram, you can also check me out at Ghost Riot Media. I didn't decide to change it because I don't have time to run two Instagram or Twitter accounts, quite honestly. We are now iTunes, SoundCloud, and now Stitcher. We just got approved to be on Stitcher as well. So if you're not an iTunes user and you don't understand SoundCloud, go download the Stitcher app. You can find us there as well at Ghost Riot Radio. If you're searching for me on Stitcher, it's Ghost Riot Radio, all one word. Don't forget ghostriotradio.com and also ghostriot.com. They're pretty much the exact same thing. I'm going to start updating all of my videos and stuff that are on that page, so things will be a little bit more up to date here shortly. And on top of everything else, we just started a Patreon account. If you are willing to support us financially, $1 a month, $3 a month, $5 a month, I have found ways to reward you for your generosity. But together, we can slowly start to build this show into the juggernaut that it has the potential to be. Head over to Patreon, patreon.com/Ghost Riot Radio, and see how you can help support this show. I'm sending you my love and appreciation in advance. Huge thanks to Chicago-based dream hop duo Grimms and Blacknight. It was a pleasure having you on the show. Richie, you came through in the clutch, last-minute addition to this show. We're super happy to have you.
That's me in the clutch, bro.
This will not be the last time we get this dude on the show for sure, so be ready to see more of this guy as well. This final track is available to you to download directly off of grimsandblacknight.com or on their SoundCloud page, whichever you prefer. This is going to be Grimms and Blacknight with a track called Grimtopia. Folks, hopefully everybody had a good and successful Thanksgiving. Do me a favor and please, please, please be good to each other. Do your best to spread some love this holiday season. As always, I'm Nick Noble, thanking you for joining us for episode 6 of Ghost Riot Radio. Don't forget, do it. Don't forget to make your presence known, spread some love, and I'll talk to you all soon. Peace.
No place like home base, home plate with the blue ribbon and the gold weight. Greeted with a handshake, thumbs up, wink gun, flowing like the water that the Nile River runs from. It looks so pretty when it all came undone, scrolled out, felt like my insides crawled out, crawled out, happy with the man I've become now. Looks so pretty when I walk through that smoke cloud, faded as they turned out, brushing off the slightest, reminded the brightness, and my own devices, take pride in my likeness, rally through dangerous valleys, and darkness of valleys, loving it madly, I'm focused, and burning like forest, you try to ignore it, and then it starts pouring, and now I walk around all thought, no talk. Funny how I act in a crisis, when that crisis is frightless and heightless. Think I better chalk it up and pass it to another bucket, packing up. You can find me in Grimtopia.